Hey friends, this is Bhanu from Stuff Block, and I am here today to discuss particularly about UCEED new pattern 2020. So I know many of you are freaking out, like you are worried about the new pattern, especially because of the introduction of the design part, part B section. So whether or not it's a worrying thing or not, we will see. We will also see how to tackle that, and we will also discuss about whether we need a coaching or not, or and whether if you are good at sketching or average at sketching, whether you should go with this B.Des course or not. That's the question that I have been getting these days, right from yesterday. So let's start about the discuss about the first topic of what is this new change, what is all about this sudden change. So probably UCEED IIT people must have, IIT Bombay people must have realized that these objective questions are not enough to understand or properly evaluate the right student for their course, and that's why they have come up with this introduction of sketching or part B section, so which actually tests the students creative and the mode of communication skill. So this is very required, and earlier they used to believe that the objective questions itself are enough to judge a person, but probably maybe they have not found the right thing. So and that's why they are trying to incorporate this new change from this year, after from 2015 to 2019, 4 years, right? So 6 years, 5 years, sorry. So okay, so whether or not they are introduced or not, but this is for some people this is a bothering thing, and for some people this is a good thing, because only depending on these objective questions, which is more of math and more of aptitude questions, is kind of bothering to some people actually who are actually good at design thinking. So this has opened a new gateway for some people, and also putting some restriction for the other kind of people. So okay, let's go with this pattern, and we will see how this helps you and others as well. So part B, mostly while I was going through this brochure, and unfortunately they have not given any sample paper, so we are not yet sure what kind of questions can come into the in the exam. And whether it will be a design based question or a simple sketching, or that is the confusion that is running in my mind after going through this brochures, and I will still be waiting for the sample paper, but until then I will try to release some sample questions and everyday practice questions, and also the materials that will help you think about these questions, which will be related to one design questions, like say I'll be sharing materials on say how product design a new product, something like in asked for MDS entrance, like CEED exam. So maybe because the question marks carry 60, which is huge, very huge for a normal sketching question to be asked. So I believe I am assuming that they will be kind of asking question like let's say design a product, or let's say design a poster, and I'm not expecting UI, user interface kind of question in this year, just a assumption as of now. Okay, and comic also can come, comic like draw a frame, narrate a story or something like that. Or this is one assumption. The second assumption is they might put two sections, like in the single question they will ask A, B. In the A part they will ask question like draw the view of a person sitting in a sofa eating popcorn and watching TV, something like that, right? So some basic sketching question which will test your proportion, line of the way you draw the lines, the way you identify the size, proportion and all that will test it. Okay, and the B part might be could be one of say for example image based question. They will give you an image scenario and they will ask you to write a story about it, frame some story about it, something like that, right? So this is another possibility. So there are few possibilities, and unfortunately for this year students, like 2020, the students appearing for 2020, you need to do the extra mile effort of preparing for these alternatives as well, because you don't have to take the risk of leaving something behind something appearing during exam, and you realize that you have not prepared for it. So this should not happen, in particular if you are very much into designing, right? So let's put some more effort this year. Let's spend some more time for the preparation, especially for the Part B, and my suggestion, you should go with all the possibilities. So like at least go get a overview of what questions the Part B section that I have mentioned, like design questions, simple sketching questions, and story writing kind of stuff, creative stuff, any creative stuff that will come. Okay, so actually these questions are interrelated, that you will realize in the later, but still as part of exam, and since you are still into the MBDS, so you are better advised to go with these alternatives and prepare, spend your time accordingly for your board exams as well as for this preparation, seed preparation, UCEED preparation. Fortunately, one good thing is because of this new change, you have the 60 marks with you. Otherwise, that 60 marks will also be going with the objective type, which is kind of complicated, because UCEED part A section is kind of difficult compared to any design exam. So this is kind of relaxation to you. So I can say this is a kind of advantage to you to use those 60 marks question effectively and get more marks for your entry into these admissions, design institutes. So that's one thing. The second thing is regarding coaching, whether or not you really need a coaching. Before that, let me talk about your sketching skills. So I believe some are very good at sketching and some are not at all good at sketching. So there are a range of categories of people, like let's say very good, and good, average, and below average. Okay, so for those who are actually below average, but who are really into designing and who wanted to pursue design as their career, not because to avoid engineering, or not because to take something which is unique, but because they have really identified their designing skills, like some, for example, as a hobby, they are doing some creative DIY steps, like do-it-yourself stuff, or doing something crazy thing. So for those kind of people, they can still try it on, because sketching might not be a difficult task if you really are interested. Okay, so if you are kind of average, below average, and if you really have interest and no other excuses, like no other commitment, like I don't want to go to engineering, I am coming here, that's not fair. For a student to enter into design, you really need to have this passion of designing something. That's actually the requirement. So okay, so for those category of people, yes, you can go, you can give it a shot, and you can start working on your improving your sketching skills. Okay, and you don't need to be expert, you just need to be just communicate your idea, just communicate your what you want to show in the proper perspective, proper view, and giving proper size and proportion to the image, for example for the human, if there is any human in the image. Okay, so that's the basic thing. So, and I can assume that you will pick up if you are below average. It's not a difficult, it's not a rocket science, you can pick up, but just that you need to have passion, first thing. Okay, first category. Second category is for the people, who are average. So they are in safer zone already. Okay, so they just need to brush some more, like they need to understand what is size, how to improve their size, giving proper size and proportion to their image, perspective, how to give the proper perspective view, from the where the image has been viewed, something like that, and just it, stroke of your pencil and all. So that much is enough. No need to go for colors, no need to go for shading, deading, those detailing parts which will be later. not even color, just for shading I'm talking, which will be later. But first learn the basics of sketching, like the basic strokes, the basic, you know, proportion size giving, basics of drawing a human, drawing a view in perspective rooms, etc. Right? So you're already in safer zone for the average category student. For those who are in already good at sketching, who have creative things, there is one little thing I want to mention here, because see, some people believe sketching as design, which is kind of wrong actually. So I have been teaching for design students from the past 6 to 7 years. So I have seen many very artistic people who have not got selected into UCEED, MDS, NIDs and all, even though they have tried for 3-4 years, right? So for 6 years, and unless that's they identified their mistake, then only they came to realize what they have been doing and what they should be doing. Okay, the thing is, for the creative people, for the artistic people, so they tend to, you know, work more on details, showing the image very good, but they fail to understand the requirement of the question, they fail to understand the requirement of the, you know, scenario, and the second thing is they fail to give the working. For example, if you are asked to design a product, say for example, let's say a multi-purpose, bottle, hand water bottle, say. So that artistic guy will try to give more of how to make it look good. That's it, right? So, but the requirement is, that is not the requirement. The requirement is how the bottle will be going to help the user, like how, what are the multi-purposes that it will accommodate. And sketching is just a way of showing, communicating your idea. That's it. Okay. So that some artistic people will do the mistake of making it look more aesthetic, more pleasing, but they fail to communicate their actual, actual concept idea. Okay. So that's one thing that this above average, the very good people who are very good at sketching should take care of. Okay. And if they are already good at design, creative, and if they are able to handle or tackle the requirement, then that's more than enough. Actually, they are good in safer side. Okay, so in any category, below average, average, good, and very good. So for these categories of people, for everyone, I am saying. So the major thing is first understand the question. So this is what I have been saying. So question, the requirement, people misses that, like what they have been asking and what we are doing. That mostly it will be different. The one who attends to the requirement and tries to exhibit his idea, his or her idea, even with very basic sketching or basic view, that's fair enough. They will get very good marks. I am the example. I have given the exam once to test, to check how the pattern will happen, and I have seen, like, I am not a good sketcher, by the way. I am not a good sketcher, and during exam also I was doing like basic sketches, but I tried to show more ideas in the question they have asked, and it worked, it gave me good rank actually. Okay, that's one thing. So that's the thing, like, so understand the question, read the question properly, realize what they want to do and what you are doing. Only do that much, don't go ahead, but do it perfectly. That's it. And coloring, these things you can skip as of now. First start or keep working with pencil, basic pencil pen thing. That's enough, that's more than enough. Okay. And other thing is, this is about sketching, and the last thing is about coaching. Yes, whether you require coaching or not. So the answer is, it really depends actually. Mostly I would not suggest you to go, because the main reason why I am creating this blog videos and all is to make the content available for free, so that everyone will get access instead of going for this costly coaching centers who will charge you a lot. Okay. And some coaching institutes, honestly speaking, some students have complained that they are taking our structural blogs content as it is, and copying, giving the mock test as it is. what is the use? We are paying some 30k, 40k like that, and we are just getting materials which is already available for free. So that doesn't make sense, unless if you feel you require coaching for both pate as well as for sketching. And if you have little low confidence, then probably you might be needing coaching. But you should be able to find a very good coaching institute. Then okay. Otherwise, if you are in city or a town doesn't have any good coaching institute, and you have a good confidence that you will be able to handle things by your own, by self practice. And that's good. You can skip the coaching and you can practice by yourself from different, so not just with the stuff you look blog. Yeah, you can refer to other courses, you can purchase some books and all, and the thing, I will speak also about book. I'm not sure which book is good as of date, because I haven't seen any book which covers everything. Okay, and the books are mostly generic, like they will cover for NATA, NID, B.Des, UCEED, like that. So they go for a generic thing, and they have included some topics which might not be needing for you, or which might be of lower value. So I'm not sure which book is very good for you as of date. I cannot suggest you about the books, but you can refer, you can get suggestions, or you can go through any way. Get some books, sample books, and try it out for reasoning and image aptitude, kind of Arihant or something like that. You can get that thing, and we'll get back to coaching. So, like I said, coaching, it really depends on you. And one thing I would suggest is build your confidence. That's it. With confidence, and with the hope that you will be able to tackle whatever type of question. And that itself will save you from drowning, right? So that much is very much enough for you to do the self preparation. And you are already in this age, like you are already in your 14 16 17, okay? So this is the age where you should start depending on yourself. You should start relying on your own resources, instead of depending on teachers, classrooms. And if you go to B.Des or you go to say engineering course, nobody will be going to teach you spoon feed you. So it again comes to comes to you to refer and study. So start from now. This is a good opportunity. You can depend more on yourself. This is a very good way, actually, because depending on self and studying, I am the example. I have done this from my inter and engineering, from the start of my engineering, and it's really amazing. Studying by yourself, clearing doubt yourself, not relying on anyone, it's really amazing. It's going to help you in future in many ways. It will give you managerial skills, creative thoughts. And I am engineering student, but I am giving design student. How is it possible? Because I used to explore things by myself. So that is the way of confidence that I got by self-study. So I'm giving you a suggestion that try with your self-study thing, and refer as many resources as possible, not just with one blog. And if that helps, then fine. If you feel low of confidence, or if you wanted someone to guide you for sketching or for identifying the question types and give you, then probably you need to think and go for any coaching institute. By the way, I have given the resources clearly. I have received the questions, type of questions which will be available, and you have the previous questions available already. So it's quite straight that what is happening, what kind of questions will come. And part B I will be covering, and trust me, the coaching institutes will also be going on probability, okay? They will also be not aware of what is happening unless some sample is released, or one exam, like 2020 exam will happen, and by 2021 even I will be able to give the proper content, like I will squeeze down the content that I will be giving in a couple of days. Okay, so until then, so these are the suggestions I will be giving. And last thing, I will be sharing sample questions and practice questions, everyday practice questions, and also the resources like sample one. I will give one example. I will take one example, solve it, and show how that the sketching and the explanation will happen. So probably that will help you do think about or attempt the question similarly during your exam. So which I have done for SEED also. So that this thing will happen probably by tomorrow or day after tomorrow. I will try to complete it and share with you very soon so that you can start working on it for free. So that's it. So finally, I would say ki don't take any tension. This is a very good opportunity. So this is opening, this is testing your skill, and take it as a challenge and go ahead and give it a shot. And definitely biggest thing is you should have confidence and hope that you will clear the exam. That is the only thing I want you to build with time. Okay, whether regarding your developing sketching or part A this or not, build your confidence. That's it. Like if you are confident, then you can, you know, lift mountain with your finger. It's possible, you know. So that's it for today. All the best, do well, don't take tension. Any queries, please drop to me. I will try to attend if I get time. And that's it. Goodbye.